Hey everyone, Dylan Schumacher, Citadel Defense, and I've been watching some videos recently and for a long time of police shootings, right? I watch a lot of those online because it's free data. It's free data that you can input in your system to figure out kind of how these things go and make you a better fighter and a better thinker. And so as I watched these, one of the questions that popped up to me recently was, why is it that police officers have a very high percentage win in their gunfights? I don't think it's because they're so much more highly trained as shooters, right? Like, cops are notoriously not that great of shooters. And when you look at like actual quals for police officers and police departments, they're pretty abysmal. You could probably go past the FBI qualification shoot right now, most likely. And if you can't, we got some work to do, okay? But you can probably do that. It's not hard. It's not that hard at all. So why? Why is it? Why is it they win most often? And I thought about that, and I think it breaks down to two things. One, police officers are trained to shoot someone when they get a gun pointed at them. Like, if you point a gun at me, I'm going to pull the trigger on you. And what that is that's a mindset. That's I'm going to use this gun for real, and I'm willing to go through with it. I'm willing to go all the way, and I'm willing to actually try to shoot you if you point a gun at me or put my life in danger or try to grab my gun or whatever, right? You do something stupid. I'm actually willing to shoot you. Criminals, so that's one side. The other side is criminals, conversely, usually are not willing to shoot people. Usually what criminals get away with is posturing, right? They will pull out a gun and they will point it at you to gain compliance. That's their world. That's what they're used to. They're used to picking on people who are either unarmed or who are compliant. And all they have to do is threaten violence, posture with violence, and the other person submits, they get what they want, and they go about their way. So if you've built up that mentality, if that's what you're used to robbing people at gunpoint, you're used to whatever, right? You just rob a convenience store at gunpoint. I don't know why it's always a convenience store, right? You whatever. But you just rob some place at gunpoint. You walk out, the police stop you. What you're used to is, if I point a gun at people, the problem goes away. So the cops pull up and they're like, hey, stop. And you just, I don't think you're consciously thinking this, but what you're thinking is, I'm gonna point a gun at this problem and it's gonna go away because that's how I solve my other problems. But again, like we just talked about, the problem there is that the police officers are trained to, you pointed a gun at me, well, I'm gonna use my gun now and we're gonna go. So I think between those two things, that's why police officers have a high percentage win chance. Because they're trained to actually go through with it, and criminals are not. They're actually trained the opposite. They're trained to not go through with it. Because again, you don't have to shoot someone because you just get the compliance. And I really think that boils down to why police officers have a high percentage win chance. And in general have a record of winning most of their gunfights. So the word there, right, the key takeaway for you and for me is mindset. You've got to be willing to go the distance. Okay? If you're not, your chances of winning decrease. If you're going to use a gun to posture, or if you're going to use a gun to try to gain compliance, or if you're going to use a gun to intimidate, or if you're going to use a gun for all these things, and you're not willing to go all the way, then I think your chances of winning go by the wayside, right? You're going to lose. You're going to lose like guaranteed, but your chances of losing increase. How about that? That's a little bit more fair to say. Your chances of losing increase. So I hope that you carry a gun every day. I hope that you carry a loaded gun every day. That's important. And I hope that your mindset is, when you think about that, is I'm willing to go all the way. If I have to shoot someone to save my life or my kid's life or life of my family or my friends or whatever, I'm gonna go all the way. I'm willing to go all the way. I hope that you think about that. I hope that you beat that into your brain. Because again, if you're not willing to go, your chances of winning decrease. And I want you, the good guy, to come out alive. So that's my thought for the day. It's kind of some philosophical musings. And if you haven't read the book On Killing, I would highly recommend you read that. That gives a great example of posturing and submitting and all these kind of concepts that I'm talking about. That's a highly recommended book. But That's my thought. That's my thought for today on why police officers win, what you need to do to win, and how to win your gunfight. Do brave deeds and endure.